AMH is a trigger word in the fertility world. You want to hear a good number when you have your AMH checked because it feels like all of your success depends on it. But this is important. AMH is not the be-all end-all of your success. And in today's video, I'm going to walk you through exactly what I mean by that. AMH stands for anti-Müllerian hormone. It's produced by immature follicles in the ovary, and the premise being if AMH is low, we have low ovarian reserve, and if AMH is too high, we perhaps are dealing with a PCOS situation. AMH is tested in the blood, and it's a marker for ovarian reserve. A lot of decisions are usually made off of this number alone. Should you do IUI? Keep trying naturally. Maybe look at IVF or even donor eggs. We put a lot of weight on this value. The truth is AMH is not God when it comes to your fertility success. In fact, newer research shows that AMH does not actually predict clinical pregnancy outcome. This means that women who have low AMH have gone on to get pregnant, and women with perfectly normal AMH have not. This value does not necessarily dictate your success. I'm not saying it holds no weight, we just want to use it properly. Unfortunately, we don't have any great assessment tools for egg quality, and this plays a much larger role in success over quantity. And that's the info we're really getting from a serum AMH lab. If your AMH is lower than average for your age, we need to then dig into how are you supporting your egg quality? How are you reducing your inflammation? How are you balancing your hormones to really optimize your success? Don't let AMH be the sole dictator on your fertility journey. Advocate for yourself and make sure you are having proper testing done, as well as all the support in place to really put your best foot forward.